got to look at some equations. Reminder, this equal sign right here means balance. It means whatever I have to the left, no matter how complicated or ugly it looks, is completely balanced, has the same value as whatever I have on the right, right? Even if they look different, they're balanced, they have the same value, right? When we talk about left and right of an equation, we're talking about what is on the left side of the equal sign and what is on the right side of the equal sign, okay? I'm gonna throw some expressions up here. All right. Later in the year, we might learn this is an impossible equation. No solution to it. But for the purposes of this exercise, I want to emphasize the center. Where is the center of this equation? Okay, you might feel like the center's right here, right? Because there's about an equal number of symbols over there as over here, right? That's not how you want to think about equations. The center of an equation is always the equal symbol, right? And a lot of times students find it helpful to, when they're solving equations, actually draw lines like this around their equal sign to remind them, this is my left area. All of this is my right area. Okay? Why does it matter? Why does it matter that I know where the center of the equation is? It matters because in solving an equation, you're not allowed to create an imbalance. Okay? All the way from top to bottom, the left needs to stay balanced to the right. And the way that we maintain balance is right here. Apply the same exact change, right? If you are changing the value of the left side, you need to apply the same change to the right side, right? So if I was to say, let me add 11 over here, I need to do the same thing here. Right? As long as I do the same operation on both sides, I will maintain my balance. All right, so that's a key idea, important idea in solving equations. Now, a couple more key ideas. Subtraction and addition are opposite operations, right? If I subtract 2, add 2, these two operations will cancel each other out, right? So no matter what I put here, any number I put here, if I apply two opposite operations to it, I'll get that number back. All right, 20 minus 2 is 18, plus 2, back to 20. 50 minus 2 is 48, plus 2 is back to 50. All right, if we apply opposite operations back to back, we end up doing a whole lot of nothing to the first item. Okay, this is an important concept. Similarly, multiplication and division are opposite operations, right? If I multiply by 3, followed up by dividing by 3, I'll make no change to the thing I started applying operations to, right? Multiplication and division are opposites. Also, remember this, because sometimes it comes in more useful to think of division this way. Dividing by a number means multiplying by its reciprocal. Okay? Sometimes we'll come into situations where it's more helpful to multiply by a fraction instead of dividing. Right? But they mean the same thing. Divide by 3 times 1/3. Right? And one last pair that I'm going to teach you of opposites, roots and exponents undo each other. For us, for Algebra 1, we're only going to look at square roots, square roots undo squares, right? So if I was to do this, 12 squared is 144. Apply the square root to that, I'll be right back down to 12, right? The square root of 144 is 12. Okay, so squares and square roots cancel each other out. All right, now, knowing all that, you're ready to handle equations. Start simple, stay simple for this lesson. One-step equations. One-step equations look like this. Some number plus 3 equals 12. All right, or like this. 84 equals some number times 7. All right, the way we solve one-step equations is very, very simple. We ask ourselves, where's the variable? What's happening to the variable? How do I undo that? All right, so right here, variable is x. What's happening to it? Plus 3. How do I undo that? Minus 3. So you write your minus 3 right underneath of your plus 3. Plus 3 and minus 3 will cancel out. But back to our first slide, I'm making a value change now here on the left. I need to make the same value change on the right. Okay? So this is what we'll do. Plus 3 and minus 3 cancel out. Gone. All I'm left with is x. Bring it straight down. Equals 12 minus 3, 9. That's it. That's the solution. X equals 9. You can test it. Does 9 plus 3 equal 12? Yes. Good. All right, same idea over here. Where's the variable? Here. What's happening to the variable? Times 7. How do I undo that? The opposite. Divide by 7. I'm making a value change on the right. I need to make the same value change on the left. 7 divided by 7 is 1. They cancel. 1n is just n. Equals 84 divided by 7 is 12. That's my solution. N equals 12. Okay? One-step equations. That's how they work. Two-step equations. Slightly more complicated, but not really. All right? I'm going to ask myself the same question. So let me put one up here. N over 3 plus 8 equals 31. And let me throw another one up there. 5 times k minus 2 equals 17. All right, I'm going to ask the same set of questions that I asked for one step equations. Where's the variable? Here. What is happening to the variable? Now, order is going to matter because we're doing two things. So first, what's happening to the variable? First, it's being divided by 3. Then, it's adding 8. Okay? First divide by 3, then add 8. Now, what we're going to want to do is opposite steps in the opposite order. All right? Sometimes teachers explain it like this. In the morning, you put your socks on first, then your shoes. Socks on, shoes on. In the evening, what do you take off first? The shoes, and then the socks. All right, so we undo things in the opposite order that we did them. So for this example, we're going to undo plus 8. And then we're going to undo divide by 3. Okay? So I put my planning over here, and now I apply it. I want to undo plus 8. So I'm going to subtract 8 from the left, and and subtract 8 from the right. What's my result? Those 8s cancel. I'm left with n over 3 equals 31 minus 8 is 23. First step done. Second step, undo, divide by 3. So I'm going to multiply by 3, both sides. Times 3 divided by 3, cancel out. Left with n equals 69. All right, n equals 69. Now you can double check. Take that. Put it here, 69 divided by 3 plus 8. Hit enter on a calculator. Make sure it comes out as 31. If it does, all good. All right, let's look at the one on the right now. Remember your steps. Where's the variable? Here. What happens to the variable? Minus 2 and then times 5. All right, first we do work in parentheses and multiply. Minus 2 times 5. We're going to undo those things in the opposite order. So first I will undo times 5, then I will undo minus 2, right? Do my planning here. I have a plan. Move forward with the plan. First, divide by 5. Both sides to keep balance. 5s cancel here. K minus 2 equals 3 and 3.4. True. No. Yeah. All right, 3.4. All right, now, took care of my 5, take care of my 2. Undo minus 2 by adding 2 here, add 2 here to keep the balance. Minus 2 plus 2 cancel. K equals 5.4. All right? And again, I can take a calculator, check this. 5, parentheses, 5.4 minus 2, parentheses, enter. I should come out with 17. If I don't, then I know I made a mistake and I need to check my work. Didn't hit pause and try these yet. I'm about to go through them. Hit pause. You should try this on your own to check yourself before watching me. Starting right here. What's happening to M? Minus 12, then divide by 5. What am I going to do? Times 5, and then add 12. All right, opposite steps, opposite order. So, times 5. M minus 12 equals 150. Add 12. M equals 162. This guy here, what's happening to N? Times 3 and then minus 8. What am I going to do? Add 8. And then divide by 3. All right? Add 8. Cancel. 3 n's equals 33. Divide by 3. N equals 11. This guy over here, what happens to P? Plus 24, then times negative 7. What am I going to do? Divide by negative 7, then subtract 24, right? Divide by negative 7, both sides, P plus 24, because these cancel. Equals 9.
subtract 24 from both sides. Cancel. P equals negative 15. All right, one more. A tough one because it's got the square in it. What happens to K? First, K gets squared, then 19 gets added to it. What am I going to do? Subtract 19 and then take the square root. All right? So, subtract 19. K squared equals 121. Square root. K, all right, remember, square and square root cancel, so I'm left with K equals 11. All right, 11 times 11 is 121.
Again, all of these, you can check your final answer. You should know, am I right or wrong? Think back, skill number 7. All right, skill number 7 was about checking equation solutions, verifying equation solutions. You can do that for all of these, okay? 11 times 11, 121, plus 19, 140, good. Also, please take careful note of how I set my problems up. I'm always putting my opposite operation right underneath of the operation that it will cancel out. All right, I'm trying to bring as much as possible a value straight down when I haven't dealt with it or done anything with it yet. All right, the way that you arrange your solutions will help more and more as they get more and more complicated. All right, I called this topic simple equations because we're going to deal with some more tough stuff. But for now, enjoy these.